Peace be with you. We come to you this morning with a scripture from Hebrews chapter 6, verse 19, that speaks about the idea of we have as an anchor of the soul, sure and firm, into the interior, behind the wall. So it's Jesus who's brought us this hope. And this hope has a lot to do with the idea of the promise of God, you know. It's like you can depend on God's promises because of his proven character, okay? God's character can be depended on. That's why we have hope. The writer of the letter to the Hebrews is writing to a Christian community, mainly converts from Judaism who have kind of like lost hope, because they've embraced this whole new faith in Jesus, the Messiah. And they are wondering whether they have to do away with the law, whether they have to do away with the sacrifice, because Christ has offered once and for all a sacrifice. And the writer is trying to assure them that because of what Jesus has done, God has given us hope, because Jesus has gone, you know, behind the veil, if you like. Because he used to be the high priest who would go into the Holy of Holies behind the veil once a year. And once Jesus died, what does it say in the Gospels? It says the veil was ripped from top to bottom. That means we've been given access into the presence of the Father. We who were people without hope, the Gentiles, the non-Jewish people, now we are people with hope. Why? Because what? Jesus has gone before us. And this is all based on the promises of God. Because God promises it, and we can depend on God's character, this is a word that can be like an assurance of hope that we can hang on to. So this is very, very important. Eh? And then we become then messengers of this hope. So hope, if you like, is some kind of like an infection. You get infected with hope, and because you carry that hope, you start to infect other people. The hope that we who were once lost have now been found. It's like building your house on rock instead of sand. You've lost something and you found it. That's the hope of a future of good hope. And this is like an anchor, so that when the storms blow, when the gales blow and all that, your ship, your very life can stay strong. So stay strong and be of good hope.